In this example, we are given that length of a steel rod at 20 degrees centigrade is L0. And if this rod is measured by a copper scale at 40 degrees centigrade, we are required to find measured length of the rod. It is also given that the scale readings are correct at 10 degrees centigrade, which is considered to be the graduation temperature of the scale. We are also given that coefficient of linear expansion of steel and copper are alpha s and alpha c respectively. In this situation, if we just reanalyze the situation, we are given with a steel rod. And at 20 degrees centigrade, the length of the steel rod is L0. And we are measuring this steel rod by using a copper scale. Say this is a copper scale on which the divisions are made up. And exactly the division lengths are accurate at 40 degrees at 10 degrees centigrade. Now in this situation we can state, if at 40 degrees centigrade we are going to measure the length of this rod by using a copper scale, first we find what will be the length of actual length of the steel rod at 40 degrees centigrade. At 40 degrees centigrade, length of steel rod is, this can be written as Ls, which is L0 1 plus alpha s into 20, because the initial length was given at 20 degrees centigrade. So at 40 degrees centigrade, that means at 20 degree higher temperature, the length of a steel scale can be given by this. And this length we wish to measure by using a copper scale on which we want to find the total number of divisions at which the length of the rod can be measured. So if we find length of one division on copper scale at 40 degrees centigrade is, actual length we know it is 1 units at 10 degrees centigrade. So at 40 degrees centigrade, which is 30 degree higher temperature, the length of one division can be written as 1 multiplied by 1 plus alpha of copper into 30. Because at 30 degree centigrade higher temperature, we wish to measure the length of one division. So we can directly write measured length. Actually, measured length is nothing. It is the number of divisions within the actual length of the object. So always measured length can be written as actual length divided by length of one division at that temperature. So this can be written as L0 1 plus alpha of a steel multiplied by 20 divided by length of one division of copper can be written as 1 plus alpha of copper multiplied by 30. This would be the answer to our problem.